have several things I wanted to bring up today on, beginning with, to compliment our engineering department, and it's good to have our previous city engineer, Ron Shipman. This project started actually while he was our city engineer, was part of the transportation plan we adopted. We had a very successful opening of the Quarto Road extension. A lot of very positive feedback from citizens and users of that roadway. It's very attractive, it's very functional, and very wise use of SPLOST revenues. And so we're really pleased with how well it's working and the benefit that it's having our community. And it does show the benefit of comprehensive planning. So I wanted to mention that and thank the engineering department for a job well done. Secondly, we have electronic cycling reprogram coming up again. We do these twice a year. They become very popular, very successful. So I'd encourage you to help us get the word out, because this Saturday is the next one. It's at Mathis Auditorium from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. in the parking lot. We even have volunteers that will come to your car or a citizen's car and remove any items. But this is an opportunity to get rid of those old computer terminals and computers and televisions and things you no longer need that are taking up space. And we all have a common interest in trying to keep those things from ending up in our landfills. So please encourage your neighbors and others to bring those to the auditorium. We'll, like I said, be willing to help people with them. And Atlanta Recycling will be on hand, and they take them all back to Atlanta and use the spare parts, so there's no cost to the resident, except for a couple of recycling type items, but the majority of it is free. And as I said, it's become very, very popular. I wanted to also mention and go into a little bit of detail, but as you know, while we are planning the new Force Main project and the new relocation of the Withlacoochee plant, we're making temporary improvements and trying to do those in such a way that some of those can be used as part of the new plan. So we had, you all had authorized us to spend about $2.5 million on short-term improvements that would help the plant remain in compliance until the new plant is online and operational. And I just wanted to bring you up to date on that. The new automatic bar screens are in and operating well. These new screens are helping to keep rags and debris out of the plant. There's also now a set of manual bar screens that have been installed and are operating well. The new return activated sludge lines have been installed in front of the bar screens, and this is helping to get existing rags out of the downstream treatment process. We have new air blowers that have been installed, and the piping is complete. They're operating very well. The new blowers for aeration basins have been installed. They're operational, and new piping to the aeration basins has been installed. We actually have made improvements to secondary clarifier number 4, digester number 1, and they're draining some of the old primary clarifiers. We're going to be using those for surge tanks. So basically, if we have high flows that the plant can handle, these will almost serve as storage basins, temporary storage basins, so that the plant can then catch up, and it'll help keep us in compliance and prevent any overflows. And the final improvement out of those $2.5 million of short-term improvements, 7 projects, is the new belt press, and that is expected to be delivered next week, and then it will be installed and tested and be operational. So there's been a lot of work going on in recent months, and we hope to have all of this done by the end of the year, and hope that that will help that plant for the remainder of time that it will be in service, probably up to 2 years. So wanted you to be aware of that. And Make a Difference Day was recently, and it was on October 26th. And again, it was very successful. This year's effort focused on the neighborhood bordered by Martin Luther King Jr. Drive, Dasher Lane, Weisenbaker Lane, Griffin Avenue, and South Patterson. We had about 70 volunteers. They put in about 207 volunteer hours. They collected nearly 4,000 pounds, which is 2 tons of junk and litter and debris that was removed. So it's a very positive thing for the community and for the environment as well. So again, that was a success, as it always is. And I wanted to recognize Samantha tonight. She recently received 2 awards from the Toastmasters. She earned the status of Advanced Leader Silver, which is the highest award in Toastmasters leadership program. And she also was recognized as a Distinguished Toastmaster, which is the greatest honor that can be earned by a member of the Toastmasters organization. So, Samantha, we're very proud of you for receiving those awards, and we actually want you to come up and give us an impromptu speech on global warming. So, somebody sense of humor. And I also want to take this opportunity to introduce one of our newest employees. We've been looking for an urban forestry supervisor for some time, and I'm pleased to say our engineering department has filled that position. We're pleased to have Kevin Jenkins with us here tonight. I believe Kevin's in the audience with his family. So, Kevin, I want to tell you all. Kevin will oversee all the Arbor Division responsibilities. They manage and maintain and enhance the urban forest of our city. He will be responsible for inspecting, planting, pruning, removal of trees, handle landscape plan reviews, site inspections, oversee our codes as it relates to construction activity and tree removal. He'll work closely with our tree commission and community to educate the public on our tree and landscape ordinance, and he'll be our liaison in activities like Arbor Day and Earth Day. And he is an International Society of Arboriculture certified arborist with 10 years of experience. He's originally from Florida, but he's been in Montana for the last couple of years. So he had 8 years with the city of Tampa and then 2 years in Helena, Montana. So we're proud to have him back, and he knows our legacy. Valdosta's been an Arbor Day, a Tree City USA by the Arbor Day Federation or Foundation for 27 consecutive years. And so we're excited to have Kevin, his wife Kelly, and their children Caleb and Kylie as part of our community, and look forward to good things from them going forward. And I think the last item that I have is that I wanted to take this opportunity to say thank you to the citizens of Valdosta and Lowndes County, Hayhara, Lake Park, Remerton, and Dasher for their confidence in our governments and in our community. A nearly 70% approval rating Tuesday was a blessing, and I think a strong statement, and now we're prepared to carry out those work of those projects that have been approved by our voters. So I know you all join me in saying we really appreciate that support. That's all I have, Mayor.